Hey guys, what's up? My name is Jake's Aki Nico and welcome back to another video. I know it's been a while, and I guess you could say this video wasn't really planned either, but I guess I'll just leave this right here. Today, Hypixel decided to release a major update to an event that I'm most likely really well known for, the Spooky event. I've not played too many Spooky events, as I actually didn't really play too much at all in the last couple of weeks, but since I not only actually on accident came across the last Spooky event to test out my method, if it still works, and spoiler, it does, I obviously had to take a part in this newly released version as well. It was quite spontaneous, which is why I didn't really record anything yet, and also don't really have too much to show off, but that's actually not even what we're here to talk about today. Before we go ahead to talk about the most OP item that they released in a very long time though, here's your reminder. If you guys haven't already, then make sure to subscribe if you enjoy my content. I will make sure to make it up for you guys clicking that button, and feel free to show me if you enjoyed the video by simply liking it. I've come across with probably one of the best ways to farm this new spook event, and I will make a detailed guide on this in the future, yet again, but we're going to talk about something very, very different today, and it's going to be the next meta item that not only already changed the game, but you guys might actually not even know all of its capabilities. The Vampire Witch Mask. The Vampire Witch Mask is a new item that got introduced with the Spooky Festival update, and it's crafted like this. The Vampire Mask, which was obtainable through reaching either the 10th place on a leaderboard, or just simply 2000 candy on an event. The Witch Mask, which is the new equivalent of this, as it just simply replaces the Vampire Mask, which from now on is probably gonna be something like a rare drop. And Ectoplasm, which is a new drop by spooky enemies found during the nights of the spooky event, and also found in the new trick or treat chests. So what exactly is it that makes this mask as OP as I describe it, and why is it something that will become meta in almost every single game scenario? In a nutshell, the Witch Mask summons two bats that will target an enemy close to you and just simply attack it by flying after it and exploding. This damage obviously scales just like other mage weapons with intelligence. And here's the crazy bit. We have items such as the Necromancer items or even the Guardian Pet for example, which allows you to defend yourself with summoned entities. This, although, is something we don't have to rely on anymore. The last time something this OP was in the game was the abuse of the unstable dragon armor. This was obviously fixed very fast, and even though they disabled the ability of the Witch Mask to work on your private island, here are just a couple of reasons why the Vampire Witch Mask, and in particular the Witch Mask, is something that is going to be one of the most OP items in the game. The bats of the Witch Mask will kill an enemy, even if they have no aggression towards you. This not only includes Endermen, such as Salads, but every mob on public islands. So here's just a quick rundown of scenarios in which this helmet will completely change the current game. Slayers or even Zealots. The bat will take care of surrounding mobs. This not only helps a ton with the progression of your current Slayer quest, but it also helps a ton with farming Zealots, for example. For summoning eye grinding, for example, I would also highly recommend getting the Vampire Witch Mask, as it will oftentimes increase your drop chance, just like with the regular Vampire Mask. Another idea for an insane use of this mask is grinding multiple skills at once. An awesome example for this would be the Mineral Armor. It does not have a full set bonus, which means, yes, you would lose out on a couple of blocks here and there, but if you combine it with the Witch Mask, you can start grinding towards a higher mining skill, down in the Dragon's Nest for example, and these blocks that you're going to be missing because of your helmet will 100% be compensated by the insane work your bats will be doing, whilst you can fully focus on grinding away. Lastly, even though the classes and dungeons are pretty much well equipped already, I am pretty sure that it will find its way into some dungeon builds here and there. Obviously, there is a ton of other uses as well, and I'm pretty sure that you guys will figure out a lot of ways to make this one of the greatest meta items out there. But here's the last and probably biggest reason for this video. The bats kill the enemies for you. Since the kill counts as your kill though, this is exactly where this mask gets to be called OP. As they are now your kills, it is exactly as you would think it would be. Telekinesis, luck, or even magic find. All stats that you currently have, even if you have weapons in your hand for example, will be applied on these kills. Which means, just like I said earlier, these bats will make up for the two best wingmen, literally, in the game. No matter if they kill mobs for Slayer progression, mobs in the Dragon Nest, or any other mob. The chances for your pet drops, for your EXP boost drops, or any other rare drops is exactly the same as if you would kill them by yourself. And on top of that, you even gain the combat XP. I hope this gives you an idea on why I would say this is something absolutely game-changing. And since I actually bubbled around way too long already, like I said, this was a super spontaneous video, so I guess thank you so much for watching all the way till the end, and have an awesome day.